but NASA still goes back to him. What does this guy know that NASA doesn't know? What will happen with the Icarus predictions if this guy passes away? Are they going to blame people who fail in predicting it, or blame the model? I don't know, but if the globe model does predict the eclipse, we would not go back to anyone's predictions. We would know it just like we know when the sun is going to rise and set someday next year, okay? Now it's time to work in AutoCAD, but first I want to show you how they measure the angles of elevation of the sun in 2D, because it works the same as in 3D. This is important because many people think that they predict the angles, but they don't. They only have it in a 3D program. Okay, so let me show you how they do it. Go to SunCalc and change the date to 21 March 2016 and the time to 12 p.m. local time. And look for the sun on the surface of the earth when it is exactly 90.00 degrees. You will find it here. Try to do what I did to understand it better. Now I'm gonna model this in AutoCAD to see where they get their angles from. So what you see here is the earth or the equator circle, and here are the dimensions that I'm working with. So I divided the equator into 24 hours, and the distance between each hour is around 1036 miles, and the angle is 15 degrees. And these are the hours of the day that can work on any point on the equator. So we're gonna start with 12 p.m. Let's draw a line to the sun that should be around 93 million miles. And then another line from the sun to 1 p.m. By the way, these lines represent the sun rays. Let me show you how far the sun is. Now, if we measure this angle, we will get 75 degrees. If we go to SunCalc and change the time from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m., we should get the same exact angle. Bingo, 75 degrees. Now, let's do the same thing with 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. So at 2 p.m. we get 60 degrees, and at 3 p.m. we get 45 degrees. Now let's go back to SunCalc and check. At 2 p.m. we get 59.99 degrees. It's almost the same, it's 0.01 less, and that could happen because of the size of the Earth. I must have used a different radius. Now let's check 3 p.m. and the angle is 44.99 degrees. Now let's see 4 p.m. and 5 p.m. just to make sure the difference is still that small. So at 4 p.m. in AutoCAD we get 30 degrees, and at 5 p.m. we get 15 degrees. Let's go back to SunCalc again. We change the time to 4 p.m. and we get 29.99 degrees. And we add one more hour and we get 14.99 degrees. Almost the same.
I did this before and it works exactly like AutoCAD, but I don't remember what radius I used. Not my fault. They keep giving us different dimensions all the time. But you get the point, right? Now these sun rays are not parallel as many people claim. They are close to parallel, but not parallel. They can't be 100% parallel because the sun is a globe and all sun rays should come to us from the center of the globe. Okay? Now let's see the eclipse on the globe model. Here is the Earth and that is the tilt. And the sun should be 90 degrees on this point right here. The yellow line is the 90 degree angle, which is at 11 degree latitude, and the two pink lines represent the moon. One of them is at 11 degrees and the other is at 12 degrees, but both of them are on the same longitude line. The latitude of the moon has changed yesterday. It was 11 degrees and now it is 12 degrees. I don't know why it has changed, but I drew them both to see the difference. They say that the total eclipse will be here on the United States, so we will see if that is correct. I placed two cameras here to see how the eclipse will look like from both positions. So in order to draw the correct distance to the sun and moon, I had to come to this website that calculates the